Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Q. You know who and I am. Back with another video, man. So today's videos, I'm going to talk about the top mods for under $50 that you could do to change the entire look of your F-150. So let's go. And really quick, before we get this video started, guys, everything I am going to list today is in the description below, man. So go down there, check it out if you got any questions. Also, all the stuff I provided was pre-tax prices. So just keep that in mind that after taxes, it may be a little more than $50. But we're gonna go ahead and get started with the first thing I think that's gonna change the look of any vehicle, regardless of the F-150 or not, and that's going to be LED bulb. So in my Enzo housing here, I'm only referring to the bulb. I have a 9087 LED bulb. Now, do keep in mind, Enzo's out housing, this is a projector housing, so LED lights may not give you the best light put. Most people recommend HIDs, but I did have LEDs. It does provide that white crisp look. Light output is okay. They're a super good bulb. They were less than $50. You can pick them up, link in the description below. Moving on to, I have the LED LosFit here fog light bulbs. As you can see there, this bulb right here is super bright. I love the way it looks, and actually it does match up very well with my LED H7 bulb from Nino. But this is a super crisp bright bulb, and I just love the way it looks. Matches up perfectly. The tint or tone is not off, and again, link in the description. And also, if you're gonna get this style housing, I only did the low beam, but I suggest that you go ahead and do your high beam as well, because it just makes the whole process easier rather than putting this in then trying to go get a low beam. Just chain them both together if you're gonna do it. Again, I only have the low beam done. My high beam is still halogen. Next on the list, another thing you can instantly do to add a little flare to your vehicle, as long as bright light, is going to be your light bar right here. This is a Oxbeam 22-inch light bar that I picked up. It actually was a sponsored product, but it is a great product, and it's super bright. Only 22 inches, but it does the job for sure. Looks good, fits perfectly, gives the truck a nice look on the front end, and again, only for $22. Now, this was only 22, but the install is gonna run you a little bit more unless you do it yourself. The install for this was about $200, so just keep that in mind, but the product itself was less than $50. So continuing with lights, I also swapped out my cargo bed lights for LEDs. So these LEDs are from 4x4 LEDs. I believe they're super bright, they're super crisp, and they look amazing, which is the main reason why I have not swapped my cargo light out here, because I just love the way it looks. I also did the brake light, which is from 4x4 LEDs, for a super bright brake light as well, so people can see me when I'm braking. But I definitely love the way these look, and again, you can get them for less than $50. Moving on here, you have license plate LED lights as well that I got, again, from 4x4 LED. They are super crisp. I love the way they look. However, they don't last very long. They do start to get that hyper flash there. They don't come hyper flash, but over time they develop that. You can see this one is fine. This one is hyper flashing on me now. I did reach out to 4x4 LEDs when it first happened. They sent me a brand new replacement set, no questions asked. I reached out again. They actually no longer sell them. So, you know, maybe they were having a lot of issues with the product. Amazon does offer another option I'm gonna post down there for you all that I'm probably gonna switch to. I think like $12. So, but again, changing out the LED license plates, bulbs will also give you a higher end look. Moving here to my both brake light and reverse light. So my reverse light is again from 4x4 LED. So they are, I love every bulb I have bought from them. It's been amazing. Super bright, super crisp. You can see high quality bulb there, as well as what it looks like in nighttime with the reverse lights on. Super bright. Can't miss it. People gonna know, it's people gonna see, and it's just gonna get your high end look. Moving to the brake light, this was actually a sponsored product from LosFit, and this is a super bright LED brake light. So if you did not know, and I'll get to this video, I did tint my tail lights here. So having this LED bulb provides great visibility, even though my tail lights are tinted. You can't even tell when I'm on the brakes or when I'm turning. So another good product here that's gonna change the way your truck looks. which is going to bring me to my next product, which is the Ronin, how you want to pronounce it, 50 cal bullet antenna, man. I think this thing completely changes the look of the truck, gives a perfect, nice, aggressive look. Even though it's small, get rid of that big old tall factory antenna, get you something nice and sleek. Radio reception has been good with this. I have gone out of the city. I'm in Dallas, but I have traveled, and I do pick up stations pretty decent. Probably not as good as the stock antenna, I will be honest, but it's still pretty good. I've had this now for almost about 2 years, as you can see, and it has not faded one bit. It has remained, it's black. It's remained black, and also has a nice logo there that has remained. It is anti-locking, so you don't have to worry about somebody coming off and stealing it. Now, if you do go with this, probably just anti-locking, if you ever want to remove it, it might be hard to get off, but this is a, love the way it looks on the truck altogether. Very small detail, but very eye-catching. Which is gonna lead me to the next thing under $50 you can get, which is gonna be the F-150 black badges. I got these from eBay. They have them in tons of different colors, but since my vehicle is red, this went perfect with mine. They are a little pain to get out, be honest with you. You can go under the wheel well to get them out, but I changed mine out to the red and black. And again, got these off eBay. I think it looks great with the truck. Just a perfect fit instead of that chrome that was there. I don't have my black Eco badges here. I actually removed my EcoBoost badges. They were chrome. I switched them to a black and red like this, and then I decided just to remove them all together just to give the truck a cleaner look. And I prefer it that way because it looks much, much better this way than with those badges there. But again, I'll post a picture there, and you can also get those on Amazon or eBay, but there's a link in the description. But if you want to keep that badge and keep it all tied together, they do have options, different colors. Moving around to the back here, you can also get a black F-150 badge here, which is what I did. This was also from eBay. These are just sticker letters that stick on. You have to kind of line up yourself, but as you can see, it looks very, very good. Gives a little character to the back end, gets rid of that chrome as well. Another thing that's really gonna change the way your truck functions, and I think it's very practical, is going to be the DZ tailgate assist that actually allows you to lower your bed at a soft speed instead of your tailgate just slamming down, as you know. So this is what the housing looks like here. Super easy install. Again, link is in the description. I did this myself, not too hard at all. It's held up great to this point, no issues with it, works like a charm. I mean, for 20 bucks you can get this and have yourself a nice tailgate. Now, it does not go up, only down, as I said, but that just works very, very well. This next one, probably one of my favorite mods I've done, and if you really definitely want to save a little bit of money and just kind of change the back end of your truck, this is probably one of my favorites. So I did the actual taillight tint. This is not film tint. I did not take it to a shop. I did it on both sides, of course. This is actually me doing it with a spray can tint. Again, link in the description below. So basically, I taped off all my clear parts with painter's tape, and then I just spray tinted it, man. I mean, this was probably one of my favorite mods. Only $15 for the can. I still have a lot left, so if I need to go back and touch up, I can. Only thing I recommend with this is just be very careful when you're doing it. Make sure my mistakes, like when you're taping off here, if you don't tape off properly, you won't have it won't really paint everything it needs to be. But just be careful with it, let it dry. Don't touch it until it's dry. There's instructions on the can, but again, that look right there for $15 definitely changed the way the back end of my truck looked. Another thing you can do is get you a nice set of stem caps. These were $6 off Amazon. Nothing special, they did have a lot of them, different ones, but this is just a nice black that I wanted to do upgrade effect. It has a nice ridged design to it. Nothing special, but for $6, small detail that looks pretty good on the truck. These next two mods I'm gonna give you, you can actually absolutely do for free. These won't cost you anything but a little time, a little elbow grease, which is going to be removing your stickers. If you have stickers, your 4x4, F-150 stickers on the back, XXT. Basically, I cleaned all that up and took all of that off. I just wanted a nice clean look. It was super easy, get you a blow dryer and you just literally peel it right on off, man. It doesn't take much time at all, which is gonna lead me to the next one that's probably gonna take a little more effort, if you know what you're doing, which is going to be removing your spare tire. As you can see there, I do not have a spare tire anymore. I took it off. Reason being, I'm on custom tires now, 35-inch tires. They're not stock. I feel like it wasn't a need. If I get a flat or anything, I'm probably just gonna get it towed. Now in the pinch, I could use that spare tire, put it on and get maybe to a shop. I just didn't really want to risk it, and it's just extra unneeded weight for me personally, so I just decided to remove it. So just some weight savings, which is MPG gain and all that. So those two mods right there are free if you really want to do something to change the way your truck look. But definitely the stickers, removing that tire if you don't need it, is going to be beneficial. Which is going to lead me to the final thing you can do on the outside for less than $50, which is going to be deleting your resonators. Now I'm pointing here because it's an exhaust modification, but your resonator is actually going to be attached down up here. You can see here under mine, there is now a straight pipe right here. I'm not sure if I can see that, this silver pipe right there. I deleted my resonators, so you can see where it changes, does exhaust, that's factory, resonator delete right there. So that actually cost me $50 on the head. Gives my truck a nice sound on startup and low RPMs, low MP miles per hour. I'm gonna go ahead and insert a clip right there, so y'all go ahead and check this out. So now we're gonna kind of work our way into the interior. Before we get there, there's one mod I did that was interior and exterior that came together. And that's gonna be the thing I get asked about the most out of my truck. The main thing I get asked about the most is, where did I get the sticker, or where did I get the emblem from for this? So guys, this is not an emblem. This is actually a overlay sticker that I got from eBay. And it looks great. I honestly just kind of threw this on because they give you three. They give you two big ones, one for the back, one for the front, and a small one for your steering wheel. I replaced my grill, so I did not need the extra one. So this was just practice for me. I just kind of threw it on and it stuck perfectly and it looks very good. So along with that, they also give you one for the steering wheel. And here it is again, another sticker. Sorry, my steering wheel is turned, but as you can see there, it looks great. Gives a nice little touch to the interior of the truck. And that is probably the mod I get asked about the most, which is crazy. Out of everything I've done, that's the main thing. But that's another thing you can do. Again, link in the description for less than $50. Next thing you can do, moving on to the interiors, it gets you a set of floor mats. Now, no, these are not Husqvarna mats. These are actually Mototrim mats, and they look very, very good. They were only $20. The thing I love about them most is, one, you can cut how you want to get the fit. Second, this big bolster rim here, when people have spills, you don't have to worry about this spilling out anywhere. And the same thing for the front. Now, I do have one gripe about them, and I'm gonna show you what that is that they just kind of stain and look white, you know, and black scratches. It looks kind of dirty. That's the only thing. Even when they clean, they look a little dirty, but that's my biggest gripe. But again, these are Mototrim mats, only $20. And like I said, if you spill anything on here, you don't have to worry about them going anywhere, because this mat is going to capture it with these big bolsters on the side. Which is going to bring me to my Govee interior lights. This is a sponsored product sent to me by Govee. I'm going to show you here a dark picture here what they look like on, but I did the install video on that. You can go back and check it out. I have since moved it to back here where my power switch is, just a cleaner look than what I had before. But yes, a nice clean look. That to me, you can control how bright or how dim you want them, and you can actually have them very dim to where it's like a nice ambient lighting in your truck and not super bright, super tacky, you know. But again, these are like $20 off Amazon to give your truck a nice little character to the interior. Another thing you can get are these color knobs. I got these from Amazon, and I think they just provide a perfect touch to the interior. Some people may not like it, but if you are interested, again, these are from Amazon. I got every knob covered. As you can see there, my piece of advice here would be to order, if you order these, order them all together, the full set if you can. I'll tell you why, because when I ordered four of these, it was like $20. Just to get this one by itself was almost $20, and just to get this one by itself was almost $20. So if you're gonna order them all as a set, and it's gonna save you some cash. Moving on to my dust mats here. So I got these again off of Amazon, and basically these are colored with my truck. They do have different colors, but I went red and black, of course, because my theme on my truck is red and black. But basically these are small little dust mats that you can see here, and they just drop down in the middle of your console here. I have them all over. I have them back there. I actually lost one. Holy crap, where did it go? But they just drop in. They're also on the door panels, front and back. As you can see there, moving to the back, you can see right here Where did this one come from? Oh, there it goes. Sorry. So I haven't checked these in a while since I put them in. But there it goes. So these look super cool. Give your truck a nice interior look. It just kind of keeps that red and black theme going. And again, they're on both sides of the vehicle, passenger doors as well. So last but not least, you can get you a full center console tray that has four different compartments, houses my stuff very, very well. I don't have that sliding around thing. It's in there pretty firm, as you can see. The only thing is you would have to lift this up to get down in the bottom of your storage, but otherwise it holds a lot of stuff, as you can see, and it helps organize things very, very well. All right, guys, so those are items that you can buy that's gonna change the look of your F-150 for less than $50. Now, I know some of that stuff may cost a little bit more after 50 after tax, but for most of you can get it for less than $50, and it's gonna change the way your F-150 looks by doing slight, small mods. You don't have to break the bank to make your truck look good. But anyway, that's all I got. Thank y'all for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and consider subscribing, and we'll catch y'all on the next one. Y'all have a blessed day. Say bye to Red, and peace.